And we're back with Charlie from Princeton. Sue is on the phone.
Morning, Sue.
Hello, very much. I'm so glad I heard about you yesterday. A good friend told me about
good.
You.
Oh, well, good.
I'm glad you got on.
Yes, I was so excited. We have a really problem in our yard. We've never had this bad before, and it's that water grass.
Uh-huh.
And it's just literally taking over everything.
Yeah.
My husband mows and makes it look so nice before he can even get in the house. The water grass is sticking up again. Looks like it hasn't been mowed.
Yeah.
And it just seems like every year it's spread further and farther. Where it's coming up in places it never was before.
Yeah.
And we don't know what to do to stop it.
Okay. Well, we just had a caller prior to you, and I was telling Angie, the reason we have the nut grass in a plentiful supply this summer is because of all the rain we had at the beginning of the year, and it just caused it to be alive where before it was dormant. So now, I mean, everybody's got the nut grass, and you can't pull it. If you pull it, all you'll pick are just a few of the roots, but the nuts where the plant emanates from will just sprout five times as much as when you pulled the first one out. And they grow faster than the rest of your grass. It takes away the uniformity. It's a pale green, not a deep green. All of that said, Roundup will not work. Glyphosate won't work. You need Sedge Ender, S-E-D-G-E space E-N-D-E-R. And you can get it just about any box store, but you spray it one time, and I think it's 3 ounces to the gallon. Then you wait about 4 to 5 days, and you spray again. And you pretty well take care of all of it. And the first spraying, you'll see possibly what you've missed. And the second spraying, you can pick up all of that and get that again. You might have to spray a third time, but 2 sprayings at least, and the answer is Sedge Ender.
But you can also do Sedge Hammer. It starts
Sedge Hammer
the season.
Is at the beginning of the season.
Okay.
And with
see, I do listen, Charlie.
Yeah, Sedge, you do. And Sedge Hammer, you can't overseed for like 6 weeks. Sedge Ender is not near that long. And we're coming up to the time where we really want to start thinking about renovating our lawn, because that's the number one priority in a landscape, is developing that lush, green, thick, dense lawn. And now we're right in that time frame between August 15th and September 15th when we want to do that.
Well, and what do you mean by that? You're not talking about digging it all out and putting in sod.
No, uh-uh.
Okay.
We're talking about roughing the ground up with a thatcher, with a thatching rake, to where you open the ground up, and then you put down grass seed, cool season grass seed, like a fescue, at 5 pounds per 1,000 square foot. And then you do a high phosphorus fertilizer, and you keep it moist until you see the first bit of green coming up, and then you can back off on the watering. But the point is, you've got to open the ground up for the grass to be received into the soil.
So you're really sort of digging, if you will, but that's scratching the surface?
Yeah, and August 15th to September 15th is the key time.
And are you distributing that in one of those little carts that you push and it seeds it?
Yeah, however, whatever way you found to be successful in getting the grass distributed out into the lawn.
Do you have to put hay on top of that?
No, you don't. Good question.
Yeah.
Because after you thatched it up, that kind of acts as a cover for the grass itself.
Oh, ask me again, Ashley. Oh,
Sedge Ender.
Sedge Ender.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah. We're having this conversation among ourselves here, but for the last hour.
I didn't make myself clear.
Sedge Ender.
Yeah.
Yep. So, all right. Well, it's always great to have you here, Charlie.
It's great
just talk
here.
About Hey Garden Guy.
You got it. Hey Garden Guy, Charlie Stocker, Facebook, YouTube. We just finished with a whole series on how do you trim roses? Why do you trim your annuals back at this particular time of the year? We did how do you refurbish all of those mums you may have and you want them to bloom? We dealt with a lot of 3-minute videos there, and they're new one every day. We're just finishing up with Grant Hartman of Hartman Arboretum. And then we're going across the street from Pierre Funeral Home to the an Evansville Community Garden, which is fabulous.
It is fabulous. Yeah. It's so exciting. Yeah. Well, thanks, Charlie.
Thank you.
Hey, Garden Guy. Right. We'll be back with more Lifestyles right after this. Stay with us.